check, 1, 2.
Okay, what's up? How you guys doing? This is Sway from the Hub.
We look good together. We could do a little band thing, right? Look at this.
Yo, I went from cavemen to slave men.
What up, Sway?
So you did a whole tour for like 8 or 9 months. Yeah. Then you get in the studio and do 7 days of off-the-floor recording.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
There's no environment like studio environment. You can do pre-production, rehearsals, and so on and so forth, but nothing is like getting those guys in a room and laying it down with that sense of permanence.
Do you feel underrated as your depth as an artist? Because people refer to you as a guitar guy.
Right. Yeah.
But you write music, you write scores, and you're doing composing.
You know, I only started doing scores and all that kind of stuff just recently. And nobody really knows about it because I don't really make a big deal. Like, nobody knows that I did the wrestling.
You know, the music industry has been stagnant for years. But you guys continue to sell, like, you know, 7 million records on the last album. Like,
in these times, that is pretty good. The Beatles have sold 300 million. So we don't see anything as an achievement as such. Do you know what I mean?
How hard do you find getting a groove for a track when you're laying down every instrument?
I hear everything in my head. So for instance, if I go lay the drums down first, so if it's Bring It On, you know, and I just keep going. Then I'll go behind that, play the guitar. Then I'll go behind that, play the bass. Then I'll go behind that, play the clavinet. So that band you hear on all these records is me. You know, it's just the way it's been.
I have to say, I didn't know how huge you were until I was in Germany, because I go to Germany a lot.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, yeah. Do you speak German?
No, but I was on an airplane flying there. This is like 5 years ago, and I was, and there was a really cute girl, flight attendant, and I said to this little gay guy beside me, this little gay German guy, I said, can I tell her she's pretty? And he said, he said, you say, ich will dich berühren. So I walked up to the girl and I said, hi, ich will dich berühren. And she looked at me and she said,
that's bad.
No, I don't think so. And I went back and it was weird. There was a weird vibe. And I was like,
I
want
to touch
what did
you.
I say?
Yeah, I want
to touch. You said to her, you want to touch her.
Go ahead, just put your name there.
No, I know. I've actually, you know, I've been here.
Sorry,
I've been...
man, I've never seen you. My apologies.
You've never seen me before?
I don't think so. You come here a lot?
Are you serious? It's a big office. Yo, Fernie. What up, man? How you doing?
Actually, can you sit right there? Yeah, that's right there.
Frankly, I want a raise. No more than $25,000. I know I don't have a car, but I think I should be entitled to a gas card. And I'm not really getting invited to a lot of parties, so I want to get invited to some more parties. Cars, that's what I want, a boat. I'd like to see a cottage. You know that poster right at the corner of Queen and Duncan of George Strom? I want that, I want something like that, but bigger. I need something a little bigger. I kind of need something to capsize George. I think that's about it. My mom said I should ask for a cat, but I don't really want a cat.